Robben Island, something like that. So he says, man, leave it out. But now since they started learning our language and challenging us in our mother tongue, the Muslims were forced to accept the challenge. And Maulana Abdul Aziz of Delhi, this is I'm reading in the book, which made everything interesting to me, which brought me here. That Maulana Abdul Aziz of Delhi, he was forced to accept the challenge. It was a certain reverend founder who was the head of that movement, missionary movement. And according to the appointed time and date, the debate started. The reverend started the debate with requesting the Maulana. Maulana means our Shaykh or Imam in our language, you see, in the language of the Indian Muslim. He said, Maulana Sahib, telling him in Urdu, sir, respected Maulana, get started. Start the ball rolling. So the Maulana said, you see, look, you are our elder brother. In other words, Christianity precedes Islam by 600 years. So you are 600 years senior to us. So as such, you have the first preference. Number two, he said, look, you are our guest. No doubt an unwelcome guest, but a guest at that. So as such, again, you have the first preference. So the reverend was forced to start the debate. And he started with a question. He says, Maulana Sahib, speaking in Urdu, Maulana Sahib, where is your Prophet Muhammad now? So the Maulana, after a pause, he replied that he is in Jannatul Firdaus, in heaven, blessed heaven with God Almighty. Out of that answer came the second question. He said, all right, tell me now, where was he when his grandson Hussein was martyred at Karbala? So the Maulana again thought for a moment, and he again replied, he was still in Jannatul Firdaus, in blessed heaven with God Almighty. Out of that answer came the third question. I'm reading this in the book. He said, all right, now Maulana Sahib, look, if your Muhammad was with his Allah, as you say, and while his grandson was being butchered, Shaheed, at Karbala, didn't he ask his Allah for help? He said, look, my grandson is being butchered, please, have mercy on him, save him. So there was a long pause. And the reverend couldn't hold his peace, he started stamping his feet. Come on, come on. Did you, didn't he? Didn't he ask his Allah for help? Because if somebody is bullying me, and if I have a young heavyweight champion next to me, I say, look, man, akhi, please, man, you know, help me, save me. So didn't he ask his Allah for help? So after a long pause, the Maulana said, yes, he did. He did. So what did he say? We know he wasn't saved. What did Allah say? And there was an inordinate pause, undue pause. So the reverend again started stamping, come on, come on. What did he say? So the Maulana said, Allah cried. He cried. He said, what? Allah cried? He said, yes. He said, I couldn't save my own son Jesus. How can I save your grandson? And the debate was over. I hope the chairman doesn't take exception to your laughter. Look,